The time spiral block draft. This format's got a lot of weird stuff going on. Let's get through it. So this is our time shifted card. Every time spiral pack had a old reprint of a rare or uncommon or common from a previous set. So this is actually pretty good because Rebels were a... They did have a cause. they were a theme here. 3-mana 2/2. It basically has death touch when it blocks. It kills everything that you get blocked. And you can pay 5 and tap and search it for a rebel. Our rare was actually not as good as it looks. Worm Calling. X and a green to make an XX, and you can buy it back for 2 and a green. Firemaw Kavu is very good. So 6-mana 4/2. When it comes in, it deals 2. And then when it dies, it deals 4. Or actually when it leaves the battlefield. So if you blink it, like flicker it in and out, it'll trigger, in fact, very well. And it has Echo of 6-mana. So often you'll play this, kill a 2/2, then just not pay the Echo and kill a 4/4. I'm going to take Firemaw Kavu. The card is great. I love Mystical Teachings. I hope to wheel it. I love Think Twice. Basically, what I like drafting this format is like Grixis Control. Ooh, Conflagrate. This card is very good, too. You get to... pay 5 mana to deal 2 damage, then red X deal and discard some cards and deal more. It's probably not going to take it here. Ooh, Magus of the Jar. 5 mana, 3/3. You tap it. Each player basically exiles their hand, draws 7 new cards, and then discards their hand at the end of the turn. So it's a memory jar. It's a 5 mana, 3/3 memory jar. On the other hand, it's also a momentary blink. And blink with Firemaw Kavu was just obscene. So I'm really tempted to just momentary blink here. This might not wheel because it's a rare, not because it's because it is Phantom, but because people just assume rares are good. And then taking Magus the Jar, I mean, I think that card is very powerful, but I think I'm just going to take Momentary Blink, though. Blink is less likely to wheel than the Magus, I think, and Blink is just really good. Also, if you get Mystical Teachings, you can go get the Momentary Blink. And you can play 3 colors in this format. There's some fixing. It's actually Terramorphic Expanse, the original Evolving Wilds. There's a couple, some duels and whatnot. Imp Halfheart, I don't recall this being particularly good. 4 mana, 3/2, sack 2 mounts, make 2 1/1s, and then when a goblin you control becomes blocked, sack it to deal 4 to each creature blocking it. Yeah, I'm not into that. So medium black card, Snapback's not bad. Snap back to reality. Oh, there goes gravity. You can exile a blue card to cast it, and you can pay 2 mana to bounce a creature. I'm probably just going to take Terramorphic so I can splash this momentary blink. This goblin's extremely Wayne Reynolds. Yeah, I guess it really is. There's shadows in the set. Every card just has millions of lines of text. Madness is in the set. All right, but we're going to take Terramorphic Expanse. Keep our options nice and open here. Sacred Mesa. Whoa. This card was really good. It was kind of slow. But, I mean, what am I going to do? Take Orcish Cannonade? No. Molten Slag Heap? I do like Slag Heap. I think I'll take Sacred Mesa and I'll try to be like Blue White Splash Red Control or something along those lines. This is 3 mana, and each turn it eats one of your Pegasus, but you can pay 2 mana to make a Pegasus. It's also Gemhide Sliver. Drafting Slivers was really nice in this set. Oh yeah, Mono Black Madness is good, John. Let's just take Sacred Mesa, though. We got our win condition. All right. So we got a plan here. Mm-hmm. Third pick, Sacred Mesa. I mean, I could see an argument for maybe taking like a Strangling Soot or one of the good uncommons over it, but Sacred Mesa is pretty busted. Not only have 90% of the people not played this format, they also don't know what any of these random cards do. There's a lot of action here. All right, what do we got? Ooh, I did like Talarian Sentinel. This card looks bad, but it has a lot of cool stuff going on here. This is a 4-mana 1/3 flyer. You can pay blue and tap it. Discard a card to return a permanent you control to its owner's hand. So I can bounce my Firemaw Kavu. It's whenever it leaves play. Bam. And... I mean, I'm not going to take a sliver. There's just a million slivers in this pack. I don't want Flowstone Channeler. I don't really want Fortify because I just want to win with Mesa, not because I give them all +2/+0. All right, let's just take Talarian Sentinel and go from there. I think our plan is to splash the Firemaw Kavu in a blue-eyed here. It's also like a couple good card draw spells in blue. Blue had some really good commons in Time Spiral. Ooh, I love me a Think Twice. There's the Kestrel, 3-mana, 2-2 flyer, destroys an enchantment. There's Eternity Snare, which was more playable than it looked. 6-mana. It's basically like a Capture Sphere, but it costs 6 mana. But it does draw a card. Don't want the Salt-Crusted Step. I'm just going to take Think Twice. Love me a Think Twice. Modern playable Think Twice. I mean, Blink and Sentinel lose value when damage doesn't stack, that's for sure, but I still like it. Would I agree in general that Teemer has the best cards? I really like Black, had some pretty good stuff too, but I guess with Future Sight, Teemer probably gets a little better. Because, yeah, Future Sight just had a lot of really busted green cards. Ooh. I actually really liked Acacian Javeliers. 1 mana, 1/1, but you can tap it to deal 1 to anything, though it removes the counter at that point. Truth or Tale is pretty bad. You pay 2 to reveal the top 5 cards of your library, separating the two piles, and then you get to put 1 card from the pile of your opponent's choice into your hand. And discard a card to make 2 1/1s. Good in a Madness deck. Not really what I'm looking for here. Not playing Buzzers. I did actually kind of like the Jaded Dragoon. 6 mana, 2/5, gain 4, but Javeliners was just a good early drop that could keep you alive. Well, you know, so your powerful cards get going. Ooh, Chrono Savant. Don't mind that. 6 mana, 5/5, and you can pay 2 to return it from your graveyard to your battlefield tapped, and you skip your next turn. I don't really want any of these other cards. But man, so many people made so many bad constructed decks with smallpox, it was great. I'm just going to take the Savant. Yeah, 6 mana, 5/5 is not that bad in these days, and then getting to skip your turn to put it into play, like, you don't do it that often, but in a board stall, it's actually fine to do that. I guess I could take the Healer. It's kind of crappy. I could take Dreadship Reef. Maybe a storage land lets you charge this up and play something big. And if I wanted to splash like Mystical Teaching or something, it's kind of nice. All right, I'll take Slipstream Serpent. This is a morph, so you can pay it face down and then you can flip it face up. So back in Time Spiral Block, I went to a Time Spiral Block limited pro tour. Did not make day 2, neither did Paul Cheon. It was one of our first pro tours, and it was Pro Tour Kobe in Japan, 2006. We then played in a two-headed giant tournament the next day where the winning team got a Kobe beef dinner, which was awesome. Those were like hundreds of dollars. Kobe beef, just like premium. Also, we in no way could afford doing such a thing ourselves, so, you know, we weren't going to go ourselves. I actually played against so we had a situation where we could play and win to make top 4. I'll take another charge land just in case. Or we were locked for top 4, but the team we were playing against were not. So, well, this is a 4-mana 2/4 at the very least. So, we decided to Dream Crush, because we played against what we thought was one of the best teams in the tournament. You know, it was one of the few teams we recognized, because this is like a side event. It was Arnost Zidek, who's a Czech player who had just top 8ed Pro Tour London, like a year and some before. And one of his friends, this I don't know, kid wearing funny pants or whatever. Turns out that kid's name was Martin Juza. But we were playing, and I flipped a Fathom Seer, which is a morph that you can return 2 islands to flip. And I had a Slipstream Serpent in play, and I binned the Slipstream Serpent. Then we beat them, made top 4. They did not, and we got Kobe beef. But that was pretty funny. So that was the first time I met Martin, technically. Hey, Martin. So what do we got? Well, we're not playing black, though. Mirror the Cursed is very good. 3-2 flying, first strike haste. The Kobe beef was excellent. It was the most memorable thing about the trip. One of the best things I've ever done in a Magic tournament, and a really good consolation for not making day 2. The Pyromancer is great. Pretty good chance for taking this. There's Calcederm, but 4-mana deal 15 is not really what I even want, because this goes away after 3 attacks. So I don't think I'm really that into it. I don't like Aquamorph Entity. This morphs as a 5-1 or a 1-5. There's also Deadwood Tree Folk is a really good splash card. 6-mana 3/6 gets back a creature when enters or leaves, but I'm just going to take the Pyromancer because we already kind of want to splash red anyway. Also, it keeps us alive for... Woo! I was going to say Pyrohemia. Oh, we've got to take a Chroma. So first of all, a Chroma is gigantic and you can potentially unmorph it. We might be able to just work our mana to do that. Also, a Chroma Blink. You play this and you momentary blink it. That's just game. All right, we're going to take a Chroma Angel of Fury over... Shaper Parasite is also really good. Give a creature +2, -2, or -2, +2, but we are definitely a Chroma Blinking. Also, we could just switch to a different color scheme, though. Ooh, body double. This enters the battlefield as a copy of any creature in the graveyard, so can be a chroma. If the chroma's died, could be Chroma Savant, could be Firemaw Kavu. Oh yeah, we're body doubling here. This is going to be great. I do like Riftmark Knight, but look at this text. Literally look at this text. I mean, this card is really good because it's 3 mana and suspend 1, or suspend 3, and then when the last suspend counter is removed, you get a 2-2 black knight creature token of flanking, pro white, and haste. Oh my god. Anyway, we're taking body double here. We've got a lot of good combos with all this stuff. Alright, so the combo, the acid trip combo, Reality Acid, you put it on a permanent, and it says whenever a Reality Acid leaves the battlefield, sack the permanent, and Tolarian Sentinel, and you just go... let's see. Give a creature -2/-1 if it... or yeah, whatever. Time Bender, this unmorphs things, or makes... time puts times... yeah, the knight is very good, but I'm still going to take body double here. I don't actually really want any of these cards. What am I most likely to play here? I guess I could play Veiling Oddity. I'm not gonna play a Simeon Spirit Guide. No, we're gonna pass this. Tabby Drake. Yeah, this is not a very green card. I'm not going to play Reality Acid. I only have the 1 Tolarian Sentinel. I don't think that's particularly good. Ooh, tap to draw 2, then discard 3. I can reanimate with Body Double. Probably just going to take Sinew Sliver here. A lot of good green cards here, but... because I also have a Watcher Sliver hiding over there, and that could just fill up my curve. That's not too bad. Wow, this card's a beating, by the way. The Treacherous Urge, that lets you look at their hand, put a creature on the graveyard. From their hand. It basically like is active treason from their hand, but you can do some really nasty stuff. Probably gonna take Mana Tithe though. Oh yeah. We are Mana Tithing here. Ooh, White Mane Lion. That's also good with Body Double and Firemaw Kavu. It just makes 2-2 mana, 2-2 flash, and it bounces one of your creatures. I don't want a second Mana Tithe anyway. So we will White Mane line it up. Slipstream Serpent. This also could be a blink target as well. This is Morse for 6, yeah. Yeah, so Planar Chaos had these, like, they were color-shifted cards, I guess. They basically are cards like Mana Tithe that have the weird look at borders that are different colors than they should be. This is forced by color, plane-shifted, color-shifted, whatever. Ooh, this isn't bad. Dreamscape Artist lets you cast Harrow, speaking of shifting. So it's a 2-drop, you can pay 3, discard a card, sack a land, and get 2 basics. Yeah, Blood Knight's a color-shifted white knight. It is very good. Cactus Swinger, welcome to the divination. Swing some cactus, all right. Let's just take this. So I might not even be... I might only play one mountain anyway. is this me or are the cards more complicated than usual? Well, they're insanely complicated. It's not even close. Because I have body double to clone it and then blink to flip it. So I could just do that. Or I could have 3 actual mountains in my deck so that if I get Dreamscape Artist, I can actually flip this that way. I don't know. We'll see what my mana looks like at the end. Because I do have a Terramorphic Expanse. No respect for the Deadwood Tree Folk. This card's really good. 6 mana, 3-6, gets a creature back when it enters or leaves. I might actually just play it. Because I have a Terramorphic Expanse and a Dreamscape Artist, and it's just super powerful. So we're taking the Deadwood Tree Folk. Also a good TV show. Deadwood, that is, not Deadwood Tree Folk. I don't believe there's a show called Deadwood Tree Folk. Where is Magina based out of? I actually don't know the exact where the headquarters are. It looks like St. Louis. Okay, yeah. I know that's where Shlomo's from. I didn't know if that was where everyone is. But yes, Magina is from St. Louis. This card's not actually that good. So 5 mana, 2-2 flying. When it dies... it comes back, but you skip your draw step. I don't like that. But I guess there's some matchups where it might be as good. So, 2 tap Regenerative Sliver. It's not bad. Wistful thing. Rich Q-Site is the example of one of the worst inside jokes ever. This is an inside joke. It has to do with the name. It is an anagram of Guided Strike, a card from Weatherlight, which is a 2-mana card that gives a creature +1/+0 on first strike and draws a card, which is like this ability. And then it has like a similar like thing on it. It's a kind of insanely complicated inside joke that really doesn't need to be. I have never been to Glazed and Confused Particle, though I do want to check them out at some point. What do we got? Why don't I open a Tarmogoyf in a Phantom Draft? Look, it says Phantom right there. Literally Phantom. Literally unplayable. Ooh, Whipspine Drake. I do like that. Okay. I wish I could take the Goyf, but it doesn't do anything. Pretty unlucky, honestly, if we're being honest. What are we taking? Probably taking this thing down here, Whipspine Drake. Look at it. This is a future shifted card. Look at how weird this set is. First of all, let's count how many mechanics are here. There's Aura Swap, that's a mechanic. Cycling. Bloodthirst, flanking. Madness. Sliver Cycling. Cycling Madness. Absorb. Suspend. Scry. And Morph. Anyway, this is a 5-mana 3/3 flyer, playable. Or a Morph that you can flip for white mana, but it's good in blue-white, so... Yeah, we're taking that. We'll take the Whipspine Drake. If I get a Sprout Swarm, I'm splashing it too, just so you know. Yeah, no, we missed on Gravestorm. Flesh Rider. This has Transfigure. 1 black-black. Sack this creature. And look for a creature with the same primitive mana cost and put it onto the battlefield. Really impressive. Really, really just... You know, rats off to you for this set. So, this card's not bad. You can target an attacker or blocker, then scry 3 and reveal your top card deals that much damage to them. I might just take Gathen Raiders. It's a 3-mana 3/3. Well, 3-mana 2/2 morph, and then you can discard a card to flip it, but it doesn't take any mana, so sometimes they'll attack a 2/2 into it. If you have no cards in hand, it's a 5/5. And it's a way to get a Chrome into the graveyard for body double. Also, 3-mana 3/3 at a surprise time, so I think it's going to be better here. Lost Oromancer. It's 4-mana 3/3 Vanishing 3, so it starts disappearing every turn when they run out. And when it dies... With no time counters on it, you get to search for enchantment and put it onto the battlefield. Do I have anything to put onto the battlefield? Nope, I do not. Oh, wait. I have a Sacred Mesa. Actually, I do. I really do, don't I? Well, this is a full art card. It looks pretty nice, but it's 3-mana 2/3, so... Knight of Circe. Jamie, Knight of Circe. Flying, flanking, and suspend 3. Yeah, they search for an Aurum, and then they... turn into the aura. It's all 4-mana 3/3. Yeah, that's kind of cute. I'll try the Oromancers. Why not? What do we got? 4-mana enchantment. At the beginning of each opponent's upkeep, that player reveals top card of the library. If it's a creature card that goes into the graveyard and this becomes a copy of it. New. Remove 2 time counters on... Nope. 2-mana, 1/2 flash, bounces a sliver, and has Wizard Cycling. Ooh, I can go get my Lost Oromancers, or I can go get my Prodigal Pyromancer. Yeah, these cards are insane. I'm going to take Logic Knot, though. It's a 2-mana counter. It's actually fine. Intervention Pack. The packs are pretty nice, too. Let's see. So there's a 2-mana Vanishing 1, but you have to keep playing creatures to keep it from vanishing. And it's a 4-mana 2/2 flyer. You can, during upkeep, sack it to bounce 2 things. I might just take Blade of the Six Pride. It's 2-mana 3/1. It's nothing special, but... I think it's fine. Oh, look at this thing. 2-mana enchant aura, and you tap the aura to give the creature +2/-2. So you tap the Flowstone Embrace. It's basically a 2-mana, kind of like a dead weight, but I don't really want to splash it too much, because remember, these are both morphs. Hey, Johnny Katz, welcome back with the 9-month stream. Wants you to go by fast on the stream. I'm not sure what... What are you trying to say here? Well, let's just take the 2-drop, I guess. I'm not really that happy about it. Ooh, Wet Wheel. Nice and wet. It's a morph, and you can unmorph it into this thing, and you pay XX tap to mill them for X. I've got some good finishers. I don't really need that. Oh, man. Fate Seal Sliver. Do-do-do-do. Yeah, exactly, Tim. I might just take Judge Unworthy because it's a removal spell. Leaden Fist kind of is, too. It makes the creature not untap, but also it's Flash +3/+3. Psh. All right, I'm just going to take Judge Unworthy. Ooh, I actually didn't hate Lumethred Field. So it's a morph, and you can flip it up and make it so all your creatures have +0/+1 instead. Ooh, Legacy Playable, Vintage Playable deck, more Salvage. Oh yeah, we're gonna lose to Sprouts from River Round. We already know that. That's you kind of bought into that when you play Tensor Rock. Force of Savagery. This is the designs in this set are just unbelievable. It's a 3-mana 8/0 trample. Under the frequently asked questions, it's like yes, it dies. This is what you want to be. See, for those who don't play in like these big competitive Magic tournaments, one of the things that's kind of funny is you can like say, you know, someone asks what your record is, and you can be like, I'm a crawler, I'm 6-4, or I'm a massive ghouls, I'm 5-3. You really want to be a force of savagery. Being a force of savagery is sick. I've been a force of savagery a few times, and it is nice. How you can tell it's a phantom draft. Aura swap exchanges this aura with an aura in your hand. New. Should I take the Lymph Sliver? The Augur Ilvec? I guess I'll take the Augur. It's got Shadow, but maybe I'll play against someone who's playing Shadow cards or something. I don't even know. Let's just take Sarcomite Mirror and not play it. Or you're a Wall of Tears. You're 2-mana, you're an 0/4. Mm-hmm. Or you're 0/4, or you're a Wall of Blossoms. You're 0/4/1. 0/4 and a draw. Chimp Funks, welcome back. Bam, we have the fire. I need to cut a card if I want to play 18 lands. I could just play 17 lands. 17 lands is probably fine. This draft is phantom and also weird. I might not need the Deadwood Tree Folk. I didn't actually get any other fixing. So it's certainly possible that I should just... Maybe I'll put in the... Like, I just have a lot of good late-game stuff, so I'm going to do this. I'm probably going to play the Dredge... No, I'll play the Molten Slag Heap, maybe, as a way to because it's a charge land, so I can charge it up. I can play a Mountain and a Molten Slag Heap, and then I can get a Chroma going with Molten Slag Heap. Oh, Corey, there's like 50 mechanics in this head. It's unbelievable. Congrats on going 6-2, by the way. D-start, you know, you got some work to do tomorrow, but you get to play tomorrow, at least. Yeah, kind of how it goes, Ponzi. Yeah, here, Wall Denial, an 0/8. Yeah, all right. Maybe I just play 18 lands. What's the drawback? I guess I don't really want Talarian Sentinel all that much either. I could just put in the Watcher Sliver. No, Talarian Sentinel is good with Fire Maw. Can enable discard a card to enable Body Double. Yeah, that seems fine. Any tips for playing the feature match? DC, just ignore it. Completely ignore it. Don't worry about the cameras. Don't worry about the people watching. It doesn't matter. Just play your matches. You're 8-0 because you played well, I hope. Or you're really lucky. But either way, do it again tomorrow. And seriously, you just have to get used to it. You just don't try to run. Don't try to think about anything different, like, because it's just not different. This set did have Venser. I do like Venser. I'm probably not going to play both charge lands. One charge land is good enough. And I'll just play 18 lands, probably. 6 mountains. No. No. 1 mountain. 7/7/1. It gives me... Oh, I even get another one. So probably 8. Probably 8 planes. So 9 white sources, 8 blue sources, and then the 2 red plus Slag Heap. And I have this Dreamscape Artist over here. So that works out pretty nicely. All right. And if I play against someone who I really need extra late game against, I can slot in the Deadwood Tree Folk. I don't think I need to do that. How long do you get to build your draft deck? As long as you want. Dude. Which is nice, I suppose. Usually takes me about 30 seconds because you get to build it during the draft. So that part is nice. Oh yeah, coffee burps. I had a lot of coffee today. Not even because I'm sponsored, just because I just drink a lot of coffee. I'm reserving my judgment on Artifact. I have played a couple games in the beta, but I haven't played enough to know exactly where I stand on it. Seems pretty complicated to me, but we'll see. I mean, it is complicated. We'll see if that does if people still end up getting into it. I can't say I understand it well enough to really say. And if you thought, well, I mean, we are playing Time Spiral Block Draft, so there's room for complicated things, but... Lee Benningfield, coming second is a great finish. I'm really happy that I made top eight. Like, a ninth top eight's pretty nice. I'm on my way to catching those ahead of me and, you know, pulling ahead of those behind. And it also means, you know, I got a lot of money and got a bunch of pro points and, you know, people remember that I still know how to play Magic. All these things are great. Getting second still stinks. I was very close to winning the Pro Tour, and winning the Pro Tour is just such a big part of why I play Magic. It's just so, I don't know, it's just monumental to be able to defeat everyone else and be the champion. And second is a lot worse than first in that regard. It's, I mean, a $20,000 difference, but it's really not that. It's just, I want to be first. I don't want to be second. That's why I play. So it's going to sting basically forever, but that's okay. I mean, I still am very happy with the finish. If you told me I could lock in getting second in the next Pro Tour, and I just clearly would, but... It, obviously, I would have liked to win there. My seven was bad. I'm not going to play first. Sounds not bad. My seven was Banalish, Marshall, Healer's Hawk, and five lands. It's just not a keepable hand. Ooh, the Suspended Shade of Troke here. That actually saw some constructive play. It's a suspend 1/2, so it'll come into play 3 turns after, and you can pay a white to give it +1/+1. Did I just do a draw against White Weenie? Who knows? New Benalia. Tap, scry one. What finals loss stings the most? Well, Oliver's not even the discussion, because who cares about a Mox compared to a Pro Tour? It's the probably the one against Nassif. Winning 2 PTs in a row would have just been insane. Yeah, obviously I would lock to getting PT 2nd at every PT from now on. Gathen Raider's Body Doubles is a nice combo. What are they casting end of turn? I have in Mind Sensor. Oh, no, no, no. So let's discard. I'm actually discarding a Gathen Raiders here. Sack an island. 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 And we're going to Logic Knot that thing. Look at that. My opponent got kind of greedy here. I guess I should just... No, I have a Body Double. I'll just do it for one. They should have just played that on their turn. Like, that would have cut off my Dreamscape Artist. They're going to regret that, I think. Are they just going to pump the Shade a bunch? Are they Mono White Aggro? What is going on here? Defiant Vanguard, sure. All right. I assume they did not pump the Shade. Interesting. Wow, I can skip my turn to Chrono Savant here. I'm just going to sack this. I'm going to get Plains and Mountain. Play a land and then play my Tolarian Sentinel. And then now I've got the Tolarian Sentinel plus... do they have Mana Tithe? Sure. I guess that's not pumping the Shade makes sense. But I'm going to get Mana Tithe at some point here, so I'm not really that worried about it. I did get debated, yeah. All right, so I'm getting hit and then they're keeping Defiant Vanguard up. I'm going to play a Fire Maw Kavu. When it comes into play, it deals 2 to a creature. Hopefully they're out of Mana Tithe by now. I'm going to deal 2 to that. They're going to go get a Rebel, but that's okay. And then Fire Maw Kavu can block and deal 4. Like, it can really do a lot of action here. I've heard of Keyforge. I haven't had a chance to play it. I'm interested in playing it, though. It does sound fun. It says Time Spiral Block Constructed. We are, we're currently, my opponent's currently searching up a Rebel with cost 4 or less, and then I'm just gonna, Saltfield Recluse. That's not bad. Taps to give a creature -2, -0. So, let's see. Opponent's just gonna pass. Question is, do I want to pay Echo on this thing? Yeah, I think I will. Like, I'm not really in a hurry here, and I'm just gonna pass because I might want to discard that island to use Dreamscape Artist. Dreamscape Artist is pretty powerful. Like, it's going to thin out my deck of lands really quickly here. Ramosian Revivalist. Return target Rebel permanent card. Of, oh, that's kind of gross. I wish I could... Well, I guess I'm just going to body double. Well, let's see. I guess I can Dreamscape Artist. And then... discard a card, sack a land. I have six lands left. And then play a body double. I'm just not playing around Mana Tithe, nor am I leaving Mana Tithe up anymore. Because I'd... oh, let's get back. Tellurian Sentinel. So they're going to get their thing back, but I'm just going to start going off with Firemaw, Kavu, Tellurian Sentinel here. It's going to be nice. We got this. I mean, my 7 would certainly have had a better chance than going to 4, but that doesn't... that really doesn't mean anything. Quilled Sliver, that's not going to do it. Oh, they didn't leave mana up for Ramosian Revivalist? Interesting. If they don't have a way to disrupt this combo, they're in a lot of trouble here. No, Gaze of Justice, exile target creature, then Bound in Silence? Wow. Okay. So they made it so my creature can't attack or block, and they just... they exiled a creature. What the... where'd all this come from? Man, I drew one of my lands? Alright. I wouldn't have locked in second after making top 8. No, of course not. Well, this card is a reason to be mono white. The card is very powerful. Alright. I need to draw... a momentary blink. That would be nice. Guess I'll play Javeliers. I have one land left. Let's just pass, I guess. I mean, I could have gotten used Chrono Savant, but it doesn't seem very good to do that, given that they're just going off here. Alright, I guess I'll take the damage again. Yes, this is a Hand of Justice callback, which is pretty sweet. Well, we haven't lost this yet. Don't worry. I mean, we're not doing great, but we are definitely not out of it. This is Exile? Yeah. Getting anything good? How many rebels do they have left? Next one damage will be dealt to this is dealt to target creature you control instead. So it lets you redirect the damage, like the other cores, and has flanking. Oh yeah, Sacred Mesa definitely could. Griffin Guide, that's a card. Oof. Alright, well my opponent's deck's very good. They have a lot of really good white cards here. Let's... I mean, given that I have all non-lands, yeah, it would be nice. Oh, there we go. Momentary blink. Okay. Just pass the turn. See what they get, and then we're going to get some Firemaw Kavu action. Here we go. So, I think I'm going to blink. So, look at this. This is going to be gross. So, when it leaves play, it deals 4, and when it enters play, it deals 2. So, I'm going to deal 4 to the Revivalist, probably. I still can't kill the Flyer, which is unfortunate. But... yeah, and then deals 2 to the Shade. Okay, and then I can blink to kill 2 more things. Yeah. And then when it deals 4 to this... deals 2 to that. No, it deals 2 to that. Right. And pass the turn. And then I take 4 here. And then I still can't kill the flyer, unfortunately, because this gets to redirect damage. Let's just draw. I do need Sacred Mesa, so let's just have this die kill the Saltfield Recluse. Yeah, Sacred Mesa. My last land. All right, well, there's two lands left. What am I going to do here? Do I want Deadwood Treefolk? They have exile removal. It doesn't actually seem that good. I guess I just hope. I guess Slipstream Serpent's a little less enticing. Let's take out that. Maybe just put in like Watcher Sliver as a 2/4. Moondray Blink is really good. I could put in Flowstone Embrace. This actually has a way to kill. They have a lot of annoying things, so let's just do that. I would like to play first. Okay. Can I draw a Chroma? Any Chromas? Anyway, we can get a Chroma here. That's a Chroma. All right. Just don't Gaze of Justice my Chroma on turn 3, and we've got this. OB Timmy, you will see how we get an Chroma. They, Stunlock, welcome back with 15-month resub. That is a lot of months. Oh, man, am I... No, they have... I'm going to wait. They left Mana Tithe up. They suspended a 1-drop on turn 2. No. We are not running into that. And this also, let's see. I'm just gonna do this so they just don't even get a chance to do anything. Oh, no big deal. Yeah, we're just blinking now. Bam. Humph. This is going to be pretty hard for him to beat this. 6/6 Flying Trample Pro White. And blue, as it turns out. They have a bunch of shades. Wow, their deck is really good. I will say that. They get to prevent one, right? Yeah. Look at this. And I can discard... a card to flip Gathen Raiders so I can Logic Knot for two. Or actually, I'll just discard a card so I can Logic Knot for one here. And then keep the Blink in the graveyard. Wabam. Opponent does have a lot of shade going. Their deck is really good. Yeah, also that new Morph token. I don't know what's going on with that. There's some things going on here. Are they going to Griffin Guide? Nah, that's just not going to work. Are they going to pump once, leave up Mana Tithe? Or pump twice? I mean, if I draw a spell I can play, then I can... Oh, yeah. I mean, I don't care if I show them Sacred Mesa. This makes my Gathen Raiders a 5/5. I never said I hated Time Spiral. I think it's an abomination in a lot of ways, but it doesn't mean I hate it. I enjoy drafting these formats. Oh, they did have the Judge Unworthy. So they have to hit a 4 casting cost card in order to finish it off with the Archer. They missed. I guess they can block and shoot. Sure. They hit Amru Seekers. That's the 1/1 has to be blocked. Yes. Lorwyn is bad. Like, I do not like Lorwyn, but this is not Lorwyn. They're just super dead to this Achroma. I can smell coffee. We'll see. What about Cold Snap? Also very bad. Do. Coffee does smell really good, too. Do I want a Molten Firebird? No, I really just don't. We got this. We got this, chat. I played a Lorwyn block flashback once, and it was just so clear why Lorwyn was just such chance. One of my top three favorite draft formats. Original Innistrad, Cons, and... like, in order, probably, like, Mirrodin, Darksteel, something like that. Alright. Like, Triple Shadows was fine. It wasn't, like, my favorite or anything, but it was definitely fine. Evanston Restored is horrendous. Which I guess doesn't answer why it's horrendous, but it is horrendous. It just all... the themes are bad, the cards were bad. It had some really overpowered cards. Ugh, they have the Shade. Stupid Shade. Alright, well, I'm gonna go get a Plains, and then at least we'll be able to... Manatide their 3-drop or something. Okay, they don't have a 2-drop at least. Playing Sentinel, so we're not... No Blink shenanigans here, but... we still have some decent outs. No Mana Tithe, alright. Ooh, are they going to Mana Tithe my Think Twice? Definitely have it. There's just no way they don't have it. Ooh. A lot of action here. I'm just going to pass, because I feel like A, they have Mana Tithe, and B, I have Mana Tithe. So, feels like this is going to be pretty good. Alright. My opponent really just needs to play this card when I'm tapped out. I just don't understand. They know I have Logic Knot. I mean, I guess they were leaving Mana Tithe up, but like, it's just been countered 3 times. Mm-hmm. What is going on here? Malak of the Dawn. It's a 2/4 regen. Yeah, sure. Let's just play Talarian Sentinel because this blocks the Malak. This Shade of Trokir is really going to get me, though. Alright, block. I mean, I guess if I draw enough planes, I could just eventually Sacred Mesa them out. Okay, so I'm going to take 3 off the Shade, then they're going to play a 3-drop. Emru Seekers, sure. Artifact and White Creatures, huh? Play a Gathen Raiders. I think I just pass, and I can skip my turn to get back a Chrono Savant. How much damage do I take? 3 plus them pumping their Shade, I guess. I might get there. We'll see. Yeah, obviously I'm also drawing Mono Islands. Yeah. It doesn't really come up very often that the suspend creatures have haste. So this can be a 5/6 or 6/7. Jeez. Alright. Block. The thing is, the Chrono Savant does do a pretty good job blocking here. Okay. If it wasn't tapped, I would be a lot less unhappy about this. That's not too bad. So let's see. I'm just going to play the Chrono Savant. That's got to just be better. Oh, good. Flowstone Embrace. Fantastic draw. All right, I can feed that to the Gathen Raiders, I suppose. They're probably going to have Gaze of Justice. If they don't have Gaze of Justice, though... I mean, the Flowstone Embrace kills the Shade, so if I was able to draw my Mountain or even the Slag Heap... I could get there. Like, that's part of the reason I liked it, is that it kills Shade of Trokir. Well, if they're tapped out, I guess. It's not actually dead weight in that regard. Oh man, they have Gaze of Justice. Ugh. Rip your coffee experience. So yeah. So what I really need to do is draw more planes. Okay, so maybe they don't have Mana Tithe, as it turns out. Alright, more planes is good. So let's play Lumethred Field. 4. Yeah. Pass. Because now I can block Shade with the Lumethred Field. Sinew Sliver I can block with Tolarian Sentinel. This gives me an out to draw even another planes. Because once you cast Sacred Mesa, you're kind of locked into using like a lot. I think this gives me... Yeah. See, this is actually okay. They're just gonna pump the Shade, and then I don't even have to flip Gathem Raiders. I can just flip the Lumethred Field, and then my Gathem Raiders beat the Sinew Sliver in a fight. Hey, NH Insig, welcome to the Divination. Thank you for joining us. All right, Plains isn't bad. Red, I was going to say, other things, they're like, basically just, as long as it's not, wait, am I just dead now? I am, I really needed to draw planes, didn't I? Or a castable. Because they just get attacked with everything. Yeah, alright. All right, I still believe this deck can go 2-1. We got this. Our deck is good. Their deck was really good though. Double Shade of Trokera Mono White. I could make a Pegasus, but I would still die. I did say 2-1. I didn't say 3-0. Chat, we're gonna get to 2-1. We got it. I mean, they had to have. Basically, Gaze of Justice got us both games, including the game where I had no land, no basics left in my deck, and I managed to draw all the lands that were there. 0-3 coming? No. If you don't wait for a giveaway, though, boom. Can you please draft green? I did. I have a Deadwood Treefolk. Boom. It's not rigged. It's not rigged. We've got this. I still think we're in good shape. Ooh. All right. We have the combo. Gathen Raider's body double. We just need to draw the Akroma now. Suspended Keldon Halberdier. Okay. That is a 4-1 first strike, for sure. This deck has some red sources, yeah. Ooh, Mana Tithe. Alright. I actually don't hate drawing Mana Tithe here. There's a pretty good chance I get to tithe something on their turn 3. Their 4-1 first strike is going to come out in a couple of turns here. Unfortunately for me. Tithe your Morph. Yep. What do we get? Remember, I can also body double their stuff. Ooh, their own Gathen Raiders. So now if I draw an Akroma, I get to discard it to Gathen Raiders and then body double it right up. Do. Yeah, it's a new morph token. Spiderino morph. Alright. I'm probably not attacking here is my guess. Ooh. Gonna keep the Gathen Raiders back for now because I don't think they were gonna block. Keldon Halberdier is coming at me. Oh yeah, we got wrecked. That is for sure. Oh yeah. Well, Shlomo, you're gonna be lost in this draft even if you did play back then because this draft format is like pretty wild. Any Akromas? Channeler, okay. Good. Gives a creature +1/-1 in haste. That's acceptable. Ooh, Sacred Mesa. Alright, at some point I'll be Sacred Mesa-ing, I think. But I'm going to play Lumethred Field for now. I'm gonna pass. Luma Third Field is pretty nice because I can flip this up and, like, if they try to Flowstone Channel or my Blade of the Sixth Pride, for example, I can just flip the Luma Third Field up and give all my creatures plus O, plus one. Okay. I'm just going to take another hit here. If I had to take a guess how many times have I scryed my Procreator, I really don't know the answer to that. That's fair. Maybe do it. Maybe do I just flip this? I guess I could have just blocked. I'm actually going to flip this because I'm just going to play Sacred Mesa and start going into Pegasus mode. I do scry a lot for mulligans, yeah, that's for sure. Stopping around Mercadian Masks is smart. I could have, if I had a Force of Savagery, it would be an 8-1 right now. So, thanks, Ray. So if my opponent attacks, I guess I still can't really block the Halberdier. I could just block the Sacred Mesa token. On upkeep, make a token. Then I can make two more tokens. And continue just going off with the tokens. Yeah, that's probably fine. I guess I could block. So if I triple block, first strike's two and two. Someone gave Kellen a sub. Very nice. All right, let's just block here. I can start throwing more things in the way later. And my opponent, so welcome to the divination, Caroline. Opponent is playing something large here. Oh, a 3-3 flyer, that's actually not that bad for me. So let's make a token. Sack Pegasus. Now I just want to draw planes. If I can just draw planes every turn, yeah. Then that's what we're talking about. Also, they don't know, but I can flip Gathen Raiders at any point. What is this? Oh my god. So they have Sprout Swarm. You couldn't see it because I have six. It's five mana. Make a token. Instant speed. Convoke. All right. Sprout Swarm versus Mesa, Sacred Mesa. I do have a Logic Knot in my deck, so I do have outs. So given that they have Sprout Swarm in hand, Luma Threat Field actually does help quite a bit here. Also, at some point I can play this Body Double for fun and profit, depending on what happens here. I mean, Mesa is better. Like, Sprout Swarm does eventually get higher than Mesa. Oh, wow. Now if I ever draw the Kavu, then I can actually just get there. Oh, yeah, Tom. Sprout Swarm is... So if you're going to be able to Sprout Swarm twice here, is that right? Wait, can they Sprout Swarm three times? They can Sprout Swarm three times, can't they? Well, so, yeah, this is... Can I give my Mana Tithe back? Boom. Slow-mo giving Tom a sub. Oh, yeah. Good thing is the Pegasus's beat the swarm tokens for now, but they don't forever because my opponent, I'm making three a turn and they're gonna make like a million a turn. Fatty us here, so a lot. Sinbad basically. I do think if I draw the Kavu, I'm still in okay shape because I can discard Kavu, body double it, and then start blinking it, and then that just wipes out so many other creatures. Yeah, Sprout Swarm is pretty good. And mine are 1-2 flyers, and there are 1-1 not flyers. So let's lose that. That's not a Kavu. I can get that back, but it doesn't really seem like it does that much. So let's just pass. 5, 10, yep, they can make 3 here. Oh yeah, Vintage Cube is coming. Also, at some point, I can draw a Logic Knot. And if I draw a Logic Knot and can counter Sprout Swarm, I think that puts me in pretty good shape, too. Yeah, this is a very neat format. They're even playing around Mana Tithe at this point. Yeah, Tromp the Domains would do it. Yeah, Kronos, I'll go ahead and try to do that. Yeah. So, end of turn, I make 4 more Pegasi. The problem is they're at 20. If they were a little less, I could maybe try to race them with the Pegasuses, but they still don't really have good attacks, right? Nah. Hardcast Simian Spirit Guide. Okay. Oh wow, I gotta make sure I don't get my Mana Tithe Simian Spirit Guide. That would be brutal. Okay. Alright, so Logic Knot's the card I want to draw most, but Fireman Kavu would also be pretty good. Mountain is not the worst, I guess. Pyromancer is decent. I can still make 3 Pegasi. Tom, Yuki did most of my emotes. I don't know if I still have her listed on my stream dashboard. I don't think I currently do. But Yuki Choco Milk, I can let you know. I can email you later. She's good. She does a good job. So I would recommend. Certainly would. All right. I might actually win this game. I mean, part of the problem here is they don't... So there's a land card discarded, I see. They don't have to do anything else. Oh, they discard a Fire Maw Kavu. Nice. Oh, I get to body double their Fire Maw Kavu. Okay. We're in there. That worked out actually kind of nicely for me. Because now I get to wipe out their giant Dust Wasp and their Keldon. Oh, the Pyromancer kills the Halberdier. Never mind. It does not. Okay, yeah, I can't save that. I mean, I could blink it, but I think blink's just going to be better on Fire Maw. Yeah, this is going to work out just fine. All right. Body Double does not exile, though. It just enters as a copy. Do I think... Yes, of course it was a design mistake. Of course Spreadstorm was a design mistake. How could it not be? Choose Fire Maw Kavu. So this is the deal 2 mode. I'm actually going to kill the stupid Seer. And then... Yeah, Tom, we can make sure you get some coffee, too. That can certainly happen. And then... I guess Dreamscape Artist is actually worth playing. I might actually end up using this to get some more planes. I'm at 12 and they're at 20. They're going to make 1, 2... 3, 4, 5 tokens. Let's just attack with. I was supposed to Fire Maw before they get block. Whatever. Let's just do it now then. Very unscientific amount of attacking here. So let's see. I'm gonna choose Fire Maw Kavu again. When it leaves, it deals 4. When it deals 2, let's just kill the Flowstone Channeler. And they get to Sprout Swarm a bunch. Sure. But I still have a lot of blockers. So I think I'm still done. Okay. I have 6, 10 blockers. Yeah. And they're about to have 1, 2, 3, 4. I don't even know. Is this fine? I don't even know. I feel like it's not. I feel like I'm still going to lose to Sprout Storm. It's just so much more powerful than Sacred Mesa. But on the other hand, Lumethred Field is actually giving me a little bit of action here. They lose all their creatures when they attack. Like, they don't get any, they don't kill any of my creatures. They have 20 creatures I attack, and I block 10 of them, they lose 10 creatures. I guess, like, I die to a lot of things, like pump spells and stuff, but I do think that this is still kind of interesting. If I had gained a few lives, then I think, if I had chumped the Halberdier with Lumethred Field, the turn I ended up flipping it anyway, that would have been a lot better. I am dead to Crater Hoof, but... Yeah. Well, Tanya, I mean, I guess it depends on what your metrics are. Like, in terms of harm done, I think that Arcbound Ravager might be the most damaging card that's ever been created. Prismatic Lens, Lanar Mentor, sure. Okay, so let's do this. Let's blink the Kavu. And so now I think I actually don't want to be a Fire Maw Kavu. I think I would rather be a Pyromancer. Could be a Dust Wasp. No, let's just be a Pyromancer. Academy did not do more damage, no. And then when it leaves, deals 4. I guess I just hit their morph. No, let's just kill the Halberdier. That actually seems fine. Like, it's just really hard to argue against cards that are in the 90s, because the player base is just so much bigger now, and a lot of what was... There's just so many busted cards that I don't know that it really matters as much. All right, so I don't pay Echo. Draw, I'm just going to play a land. If it was a non-land, I might Dreamscape, but I'd rather just get the 3 now. All right, let's just pass. Yeah, Mirrodin Standard Slow-Mo was the worst, because if you look, the players just dropped off a cliff there. So right now I've got 12... 15 blockers, and then they're going to have... I don't know how many attackers. They can figure it out. Like, sure, like, Winter Orb, the Abyss, Mana Drain, you know, Arborea, Caracas, all these other cards from Legends are really, really bad designs in terms of, like, the actual card design, but I don't think that they just had the impact that Arcbound Ravager did. What is my plan for actually winning the game? Well, I've got flyers. Oh man, I remember Frank and Sons Corrupt Acolyte. That was where I played my first vintage tournament. I don't know why Sprout Storm is doing anything that it does. So they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 14, 20. 26 things. Hey, Corrupt Acolyte, welcome to the divination. I have 12, 15, so I'm going to take 11 damage. So they actually could kill me by just casting it without kicker here. I believe we're going to win this match. Change my mind. Actually, it's kind of on my opponent. Change my mind. Frozen Phoenix, I like the art, divination art that appears on my channel right here. I think it's pretty good. I guess they're wondering if there's a morph I can play that does something. The answer is no, not really. I needed the Pyromancer to not die. If they hadn't killed the Pyromancer, it would have been a lot better. Utopia Vow. Alright. They did the math. All right. That was game one. Do I have anything that stops Sprout Swarm? I mean, technically this, but honestly, the fact that, first of all, Mana Tithe gets it some amount of the time, even if they know I have the Mana Tithe in the deck. Second, I do have a Logic Knot over here, so Logic Knot also gets it. So I'm kind of just going to be relying on those things. It's going great, Draco Spell Blast. Yeah, I think this is fine. Oh man, if my morph was Fortune Thief, yeah, right side, that would be insane. I played Fortune Thief at the Time Spiral Block Pro Tour. That was nice. So, reminder, we've got stakes on the line here. Well, not stakes, actually. Coffee. If I win, I'll get to give away some more coffee. But don't worry, we've got some more coming. Oh, I'm glad you like it, Cup Noodles. Spindrift is good. Spindrift is good. Yeah, I don't think I want Deadwood Tree Folk. Alright, yeah, I'll play first. Ooh, I like this hand. Hey, Beether, welcome to the Divination. Thanks for joining us. Thanks, Wayne Gretzky. You miss all the shots you don't take. Wayne Gretzky, Michael Scott. Yeah, see, exactly, Edox. The reason I bluffed at the Pro Tour wasn't to increase my win percentage. It was because I just want Magic to be more fun, more entertaining. Like, that's like the whole point. I mean, I'm not going to say that the people who take it, like, super seriously, super game phase, just try to play as best they can. Nothing wrong with that, obviously. I would never say that. But I do think that, whoa, I'd go over there. I do think that Magic could use more showmanship, and I really did want to get people excited and do that. Ooh, ready for a Chrono Savant on turn three? Yeah. Hi, Walk Without Rhythms kitten. I do love me a Slope Sergeant. What, they have Pyrohemia also? I mean, they don't have a second land, so they're just going to sit here making Llanowar Elves tokens. Llanowar Elves tokens. But this card's busted. It's basically Pestilence. Yeah, Sponzy, exactly. Like the gut shot. I just... You're going to Sinaloa again? Didn't you just have tacos, Matt? I don't know. I think Magic needs more of that, not less. So I'm a big fan of people buffooning it up. Oh, this is going to be good too. Watch. So I'm going to... Let's see. Do this. Discard Chrono Savant. Sack a land. I'm just going to get planes here. I guess it's not like Time Vault. They get to see the fact that Chrono Savant's coming in. Oh, they didn't. They didn't use Llanowar Mentor. They did not realize that it was going to be their turn again. See, this is sweet. My opponent got an RTFC. In fact, it's Time Spiral. I got an RT every card. Read the every card. Yeah. See, we got him. We got him good. A Magic Hobo. Welcome to the Divination. Thank you for joining us. Classic Magical Hobos. We're going to start Mesaing soon, but I want to use this Dreamscape Artist a few more times. Let's get in there with this Chrono Savant, though. Thick Chrono Savant. Do I actually cast the Sacred Mesa? Yeah, let's do that. Let's do this. Discard White Mane Lion. Just want to get planes, Sacred Mesa, and then play Terramorphic Expanse. Well, I don't think we're going to get Sprout Swarmed out this time. Am I going to play in the next Pro Tour? Yes. I just got second at the Pro Tour. Of course I'm going to play. And I'm on a pro team, even. One Plank the Elder. Welcome to the Divination. Thank you for joining us. They just got a Char Rumbler. A -1/-3. These cards are wild. -1/-3. But it has double strike and you can pump its power. This is coming back two turns. How viable Lich's Mastery is in Standard right now? Fun, but not particularly good. All right. We're going to game three. Didn't see anything that made me want to side particularly differently. So let's get in there. I like the Dreamscape Artist. It's been doing some work. Do I see another three top eights in a row? Well, no, clearly I'm not favored to do that. But I am live. You know, just top eighted this one. Lich's Mastery is very good design, Kronos. It perfectly encapsulates the whole experience. I think it just comes out very nicely. Which guild am I most excited for? Probably Simic. Simic's all is really fun. Yeah, this will do. If they play a Llanowar or Mentor, I get to Javelineers it. They suspend a Halberdier. Well, I get to Javelineers that too. Alright, can I just draw my red source? Or my... hopefully my Dreamscape Artist? Okay, well... I'm going to attack, because... I didn't play a Javelineers not to get damage in. Did I ask Nassif how to cope with finishing second in a GP? I don't understand that question. Morph? We'll tithe the morph. That'll tithe me over till the next thing comes out. Gathen Raider, sure. Mountain? No. Judge Unworthy? Can I get a land? Any lands? I don't know if the next PT is confirmed modern. I could not tell you that. Mm-hmm. The Char Rumbler, sure. Land. Well, at least I have outs to Sprout Swarm in a longer game here. And I have Judge Unworthy, so I get to scry if I need to. It's my party, I can scry if I want to. What? Stupid. Alright, I thought I was going to get their Keldon Halberdier. Well, the good thing is I can Judge Unworthy the Keldon Halberdier. The bad thing is I have to put a card on top. If I do, I can't put a land on top. Yeah, I still think I don't want to take 4 damage here. Okay. Really don't want... I think I'm going to put... Well, put on the bottom... Put on top. Draw. Pass. I just don't think I can cast Sacred Mesa here. I just have to hope they don't play something too big. If this is Sentinel Wood Readers, like, I can live with that because it means I'm not actually getting attacked this turn. Then I'm just going to pass. I have Logic Knot up, and then maybe get a Kronos Avant play next turn. Maybe draw some lands. I mean... Right now I'm going to take 3 damage here, and they're going to pump Char Rumbler twice. Yeah, this is fine. Yeah, they're going to pump that thing. I mean, or they pump it once, so they just don't even do damage with it. Okay. Cool. If they play like a 6-drop here, I have to Logic Knot it, even though I know that I want to save it for Sprout Swarm. That I can live with. This is bad. I just can't afford to not play something here, even... And if they had Sprout Swarm, I feel like they might have played something differently. Holy crap. Wait. No, you have to pay 2 green to... I can't body double it? So what do I do here? Like, Sacred Mesa just doesn't accomplish much. I just have so much stuff going on here. I'm just going to play this, and I'm just going to make a Gathen Raiders. It's not like I'm really thrilled about it, but I don't see it getting a lot better. What I like in Modern right now, I don't know Modern well enough to have like a firm recommendation. I mean, again, if they have Sprout Swarm, I'm going to lose. But if I let this resolve, I would also lose. So if they pump this 3 times, they can pump this 3 times and it'll become a 2-3 double strike. Okay. We'll block. What appealed to me? I mean, like I said, I just haven't played Modern right now. I'm not really... really doing much. Yeah, I'm not going to clone the 4-1. They have a Flowstone Channeler in play. Okay, okay. If they don't draw Sprout Storm, we're doing just fine here. They don't have a Sprout Storm yet. Come on. I almost would be am happy when they just play a random crappy creature, because it just means they don't draw a Sprout Storm. No cards, and this pings for one, but only if you have no cards in hand. Psh, don't care about that at all. Chat, we're doing it. We're winning right now. We are winning by a fair amount right now. We just have to not get jebaited with Sprout Storm. That's not a Sprout Storm. That's just a crappy card. Fadia Seer. It says pumps for... All right, we're just going to keep it... We're going to keep the Kavu alive. Yes. Do-do-do. Coffee, coffee. It's like a... I remember going to like a Warriors game, I think it was. Or maybe it was a Nuggets game, actually. So they're going to pump... I would rather kill the wall, I think. And if the opposing... If the team scored enough, there was a... Taco Bell gives away like a free taco. And they got... It was like they had to get over 100 points. They're like at 90 points and everyone in the whole arena's going, tacos, tacos. All right. Here we go. Here we go. So that kills that. Pass the turn. Upkeep revealed Sheevan Sand Mage. That's the... Choose one, removes time counters from suspend. Yeah, whatever. It doesn't matter. It's in their graveyard now. I'm not going to Chronos launch if I can help it. Coffee. Yeah, exactly. Like an ace game or whatever. All right, so... They can hit me, because currently if they play their last card, it's a flashback, yes. Oh, interesting. So they can't use the Megalith now, because they have to be Hellbent. Well, I'm still just going to attack anyway. Like, if they block and then shoot, okay, they go to four here. Now it's just time. Now I actually think Sacred Mace is not going to do it. Or, sorry, Sprout Storm's not going to do it. Wow, what could they have drawn that they wouldn't play to use Megaliths? They got their mountain. Okay. Splash card? Yeah. That might be the case. Still very weird. Because we didn't see anything that they splashed game one. Pyrohemia. That's cute, but it's not going to do it. Well, if they'd play... Yeah, we haven't seen any lands or anything, so... Let's go Mesa. Everbot's kind of aggro. So now they're going to Pyrohemia twice, maybe. I'll just let this happen. Sack of Pegasus. Attack with everything. It does not negate Mesa, because it does damage to them too. So they can ping everything for one if they want. So they're going to three here. It's going to be hard for them to get out of this, I think. Also, I can just Chronos Amont at some point. Ooh, they took the damage. I like that. Every point counts, because every point is a turn of fogging Arid Mesa. Also, I can let this die eventually, because at the beginning of the end step, there's no creatures. Like, if they ping there, then I would just let the Pyrohemia die. Alright. Let's make a token, and then actually think twice, since at this point, they're going to have to Pyrohemia anyway. untap, sack the token. The only question is who's going to enjoy this delicious free coffee, because we got there. They got a mountain. Hooray for them. All right. And pass the turn. Dragon Gola, welcome back to the 29-month 30 sub, and bam! Chat, I did not let you down. All right, we're running a giveaway. Type in coffee. You can join the giveaway. We'll be giving away free coffee very soon here. Chat, I promised a 2-1. We're 1-1 right now. Feeling good about this. We have until our next match starts to get some free coffee. Ma, ma, ma. Mods and Martels and Sponsies will also get free coffee because I'm going to send them some coffee, but they can still join the giveaway. All right. Let's join the match. And let's see who wins. The winner is Tiki Mick. Tiki Mick, can you go ahead and say something in chat or give me a PM and I will send you a nice message here. Can you at me when you say something? Oh, there you are. All right. I see ya. And just message Mully or Squirrel. And, oh, here we go. We will keep this hand. Bam. Tom Martell gifted a free sub to Tiki Mick. Wow, so you get coffee and a free sub. We'll be going away more soon here, though. The giveaway value is, in fact, real. So, I would say that the... Whoa. You're not going to be aggressive. Well, that makes me actually want to play the Sliver instead of the Blade of the Six Triplied. So, you know, our new sponsor, Majinus Coffee, gives the stream some nice benefits. Let me list them out in order of importance. Number one, free coffee. Doing giveaways for free coffee. You can join the giveaways after each successful match or the giveaway I just linked there. There's also the benefit of 40% off when you order coffee using that link down there or the code LSV. And not insignificantly, it does mean I will stream more. So I would highly encourage folks to, you know, reap the benefits. And even if you don't drink coffee, the fact that I'm going to stream more is something I think most people are in for. So, oh no, do they have the Gathen Raiders? Oh no, disaster. I thought about not attacking. Oh, they have Fathom 2. Oh, that's really good for me. It used to be this card was busted because you could stack damage, then turn it face up, so they would have killed my creature. But here they just gushed. But gushing on turn three is just not that good. So, bam. No, Seth, CFB has been great to me and always will be. I mean, I'm one of the owners. But this is a tiebreaker for, like, streaming versus making a video, for example. Well, Tom, in that case, enjoy the coffee, I guess. So this is, they discard a card. Yeah, that card's good. But see, look, they had to play that face up. It's just not even that good. I guess I'll send in with the Gathen Raider, see if I get any bites here. And let's go Blade. And I think I might Chrono Savant off the Gathen Raiders end of turn. We'll see. So far doing all right, GG Withrow. Folks, we just officially released Eternal on Steam. And if you enjoy Eternal and want to leave us a review, that would be awesome. If you've played the game and have thoughts on it, I think it would certainly help us a lot. Reviews are definitely very important to indie game developers, or not indie game developers, as it turns out. So could certainly, use the help. Anyone who's played who wants to leave a review, that would be great. Same goes for Xbox once we come out in a couple days. Yeah, I mean, I'm Chrono Savanting here. I don't mind that too much. They didn't even do anything with their turn. Yes, Tom, as a fellow small indie game developer. So we're going to... Whoa! That's brutal. They get to exile a card from the graveyard. And I still skip my turn? This is like the biggest blowout I've ever seen. I honestly have not... They literally paid 3 mana, 3/2 flying. Target opponent discards a card, take an extra turn. Dear Lord in heaven. And they got to bounce their Fathom Seer? Okay. Well, we went from crushing this game to losing to some degree. I don't know. Wow. I don't know. I mean, it depends on... Yes, that was... That was a lot of stock mana. I don't know. It's going to depend on what else my opponent has here. The game's not just over, but dear Lord, that was bad. Stonecloaker or Chrono Savant? Oof. That's sick. All right. That's pretty sick. If I draw lands here, especially if I could eventually cast this Firemaw combo, I'd be pretty happy. Let's see. Do I want to play Lumith Redfield? Yeah. Let's just wait on the Mesa here. I think there could be blocks here that end up being pretty good for me. Like, yeah, do that. Oh, yeah. Okay, we might be getting our money back here. 1-1 on the 3-1 is very appealing, and then 2-2 on the 2-2, and then Lumer Threadfield. The Innocuous Morph pre-combat. Okay, well, they're going to Fathom Seer. That's totally fine. They have 10 cards in their hand. They're not going to be discarding. All right. I actually like my position once again. Even if they play a card, they still have to discard two cards here. My opponent does like Unmorphing Fathoms here. Winning the game when your opponent Stonecloakered your Chrono Savant is pretty nice. And I think I've got a good shot here. Especially if I draw a mountain, it's just game. Because I get to Firemaw Kavu their Stonecloaker. Even if I don't, Sacred Mesa is going to start to get put in some work. And then I also am pressuring my opponent fairly well here. Okay, Morph's not going to do too much. They have to discard two cards here. Mountain? Oh, Plains actually is not the worst, because now I'm just in like triple Sacred Mesa mode. Yeah. Also, Sacred Mesa Lumen Threadfield is very good here. Pass. They take three and trade off for their morph, and then I play Sacred Mesa, which makes a 1/2, so you can eat the Narcomoeba, and then I can double block the Stonecloaker eventually. Bam. Okay. Feeling good about this, chat. Feeling quite good about this. Oh, wow. I don't think my opponent necessarily thought this through completely. Yeah. That was aggro. The Lumithread Field Sacred Mesa combination is real. Make my 1/2 Pegasi. Pegasuses. My opponent did cast Time Walk and Gush. But I do, yes. I basically was... Flying spider spawning, flighter spawning. At this point, I just want to draw planes, and who cares? Oh, I guess I didn't need to. Well, actually, I think making upkeep makes sense because this way I can attack with my business. I don't know what they have here. Judge unworthy or another flash creature or something, but I'll still just attack with the sliver anyway. This is game one. All right, they have 7 cards in their hand that didn't play anything? What is going on here? Okay. Yeah, I don't care about the Mind Sensor. That just trades for two mana. Mm-hmm. Gushing on turn three is aggressive, especially turn three during the opponent's turn. Molten Slag Heap is in here, Rutro Raggy, because I have an Achroma and I want some outs to flip Achroma. Plus the charge lands are kind of powerful. If you just sit there and just keep charging them, eventually they do something. Chat, we might be nearly time for a non-caffeinated drink here. Heresy, I know. I don't know exactly how my terms of sponsorship work. Am I allowed to drink non-coffee drinks, or do I just have to drink coffee forever? there are worse fates. All right. Yeah, opponent's pretty dead here. It is kind of brutal that I can't cast this Fire Maw Kavu. Actually, I think I'm going to... Yeah, I'm just going to... I'm not attacking with the Pegasi anyway, so let's just do this. I guess if I drew literally Mountain, I would, but now I'm making four a turn. Let's get the Gathen Raiders in there. I'm just going to attack with the Sinew Sliver too, because they don't have any free blocks. Oh man, a Chipotle sponsorship? That would be nice. Awesome, Walk Without Rhythm. I'm glad you did. Again, 40% off. That's a pretty big discount. So, also helps. See, look, if you order coffee, then it makes my sponsor happy, and that makes me happy. That means I stream more, and I get more coffee, and give away more coffee, and it's a virtuous cycle where everyone gets coffee and streams. Geo Cobb, welcome back with the 7-month resub. There we go, Madrina's Mug. Yeah, that'll work too. All right, sure, pass. Really confused about what my opponent has going on. The funny thing is, we actually had this in the works even before the Pro Tour, but getting second was just good timing. Actually, funnily enough, for those who were around back then, we announced ChannelFireball.com. We launched the website after I got second in Kyoto, which we were already going to do, but getting second in Kyoto was a good way to kick it off. So maybe the answer is just sign up for cool deals and then watch the Pro Tour second place finishes roll in. Already dead. Let's make a Mesa token upkeep because I think I actually can attack with everything now. So they go block. They take four and go into one. I guess there's just no point attacking with the Sinew Sliver, but I'll attack with the Gathen Raider still. Yeah, I actually did spoil the second place finish inadvertently. Boom. Tom, we're sending you a bunch of coffee, so I don't know about this whole sleeping for a week plan. Thanks, World B. Freeman. Pass. Eat some things. Hope their morph isn't something that makes all their creatures unblockable or something. Because, I mean, I get to make three more tokens. And they don't even have lethal unless all of their creatures get through, so it's going to be pretty hard. Yeah. Oh, what do they have? Brine Elemental. Whoa, Pickles itself. This is the old Brine Arena. Okay, so we're up a game playing a blue-white Mono Fathom Seer control. Here we go. Oh yeah, you've been doing weird time. I'm sure you have a lot of, Tom, I'm sure your work has a lot of time zone stuff going on where there's just things happening all around the world where you just have weird hours. That sounds like it. This coffee's not for US residents only. We ship international. Thank you, PJMR. Oh, just me giving away tons and tons of coffee by winning so much. I've actually won one in this draft, but I promised I had a 2-1. Lost round one, was down a game round two, but we're getting there. We're up a game here. All right, I will mulligan this hand. I think it's better than five. Ooh. But not by, tons. Hey, what's up, Riot Mages? Bam. Yeah, that's unfortunate. send for one. I mean, if they have a judge unworthy, so be it. Not feeling any better, Gabby? That sucks. Well, that sucks. How are the Pokemons, though? And can I get you anything? Yes, that deck was called Pickles because it was Brine Elemental. Let me find the... The deck that we played at U.S. Nationals in 2007 is seriously one of the worst decks that... It was one of the coolest decks, but it was not... It had some stuff going on. It's just one of the weirdest decks I've ever played. It was loose and great. Alright, let's see if I can find it here. MJ top 8ed there. Even Mind Sensor? I'm gonna actually let that happen. Wow, they didn't want to trade? Because I've got a Javna leader ready to just go. Look at this thing. Nope. Arcanus the Omnipotent. Vesuvian Shapeshifter plus Brine Elemental. That's the Pickles lock. Some Willbenders for value, I guess. Avenser, Teferi. All these new arts are offensive, by the way. Krovax to Cord 4. A bunch of Loxodon Hierarchs and Wall of Roots. And Mystic Snakes. And then you had Compulsive Research X4. Farseeks to Ramp. Runesnags as Counterspells. Romana as Counterspells. And Cord is tying it all together. Oof, that deck was sweet. I loved it. That deck was sweet. Yugi dude, welcome to the divination. Just Google US MTG US Nationals 2007. Yeah, how come every single one of my opponents just has a Mind Sensor? I'm just going to discard this Chrono Savant and hopefully not get... Oh man, am I going to get Stone Shakered here? Like, they can bounce their Mind Sensor when I try to Javelin Leader and get my Chrono Savant? Black Low Disco, welcome to the divination. Yeah, I'm just going to shoot this now. Like, if they have the Stone Shaper thing, then they have it. Yeah, Stone Cloaker, yeah. I mean, I have one land in play and it's turn 5. I'm not very optimistic about my chances of winning to begin with. Shh, 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 shh. That sounds like fact, Martin, despite it being complete nonsense. Okay, we're done here. Whatever, that was a gimme. We just give them a win. You know, we've got this. We'll be doing just fine here. That Stone Cloaker's a beating against me, by the way. The fact that they get to get my body double sometimes too. Like, I guess it doesn't, the body double doesn't target, but it's still pretty annoying. So, if I draw blue, I can play white main. Or, sorry, think twice. If I draw blink, I can just really go off. Oh, there's a blue. Very good. Good. Martin, message me on Facebook or something to remind me to hook you up with some coffee. Same with you, Martel. Or send me an email or whatever. All right. Ooh, the Slag Heap. Let's just play my Morph. It's not like they can kill it. And then this way, if I draw Blink, then we're really getting there. And if I don't... VIP came out pretty recently, Tom. Actually, that's a good point. There you go. You're a VIP now. Oh, is that Martin's list? That's not a blink at all. Let's just play the Talarian Sentinel because it's like a decent blocker. And I'll just pass. I don't really want... They have Gathen Raider. Oh, no, they have Fathom Seer. I actually probably could have attacked with my Morph, but whatever. This is Time Spiral Block Draft. Woohoo. Yeah, it's a side grade. This can bounce two creatures, sure. I guess that means my combo is not going to happen anytime soon here. Let's see. Yeah, let's put storage counter on. And then make a red and then make a pyromancer and then pass. And if they want to sack this to bounce two things, they can just go ahead and do that. I'm not really that worried. Ooh, I got that Nurk Amoeba. I got the beast in my sights. Ooh, I loved 4C. We played this in block. We had like one copy of 4C. It was great. Well, to be fair, Shlomo, you even said, like, I'm not even allowed to do mod action, so it's perfect. What did they scry? Eh, who cares? I honestly just don't care. They can scry however they want. Yeah. I like that line of process, like, thought process. Like, wait, no, this just doesn't work. That is the answer. It just does not work. All right, let's just play Sacred Mesa. And we'll just start going off with that because we got nothing better to do. I'm assuming this is a Fathom Seer. No, destroy target enchantment. Oh, no, that's fine, actually. I have Telerian Sentinel. Blue, and I'm just going to discard a white main line. It doesn't do a whole lot for me right now. And... oh, I was supposed to make an enchantment, a Mesa token, right at the same time. Well, that's okay. Let's just ping the Nurk Amoeba here. I kind of just want to block here. Because if they want to flip their Fathom Seer, they can, and I can just finish off the Fathom Seer with the Pyromancer. I don't have a momentary blink right now, and if I eventually find a body double, then I can just do that instead. If they pass, I am just going to pass, I think. Yeah, it was a Fathom Seer. All right. This is pretty good. Tom, the good thing is, it doesn't take that long to get back up to speed. It does take some, like, you know, some dedicated time, but certainly something you can do. Okay, they're going to Stonecloak her. Sure. I mean, it's going to make, I mean, making my life a little harder. They're probably going to get my Think Twice by not getting a free Pegasus, but I think I'm still doing fine here. The Pyromancer is a big game. Because I can still make two tokens now. I guess they can bounce. Yeah, they can bounce their Kestrel, but then I still get to Telerian Sentinel the Sacred Mesa again. And now that they can only bounce this on upkeep, I don't think I necessarily play around. Actually, they're not even going to really get a good attack. Hey, CVM, Chris Van Meter, welcome to the Divination. Hope you've been enjoying Eternal, by the way. I've seen that you've been battling. I think that's pretty sweet. Let's make a Sacred Mesa token. So how am I blocking here? I'm going to make two tokens. I'm just going to double block Stonecloaker and then block the Augur with Telerian Sentinel. And then finish it off with the Pyromancer. I'm running the risk of them getting to kill my Sacred Mesa by having a bounce spell for the Cloud Chaser Kestrel, but that's fine. Do they have a pump spell? I'm like kind of all in on this Sacred Mesa at this point. But there's just not that much they can have here. Hey, later DC Sports. Good luck tomorrow. I hope you get there. They have the blink for the Kestrel. Well, I couldn't have actually saved it with the Sentinel anyway. All right, that is fine. Because now they get to. Because if I had bounced it, they would. They basically would just get to keep harassing it. The problem is that it doesn't play around the bounce spell. They just bounce this before damage. So it doesn't really do a whole lot. Okay, well, all my cards still cost them a ton here. All right, let's just play Sinew Sliver, play pass the turn. Do I like doggies? Obviously I like dogs. Dogs are great. There were no contraptions in this set. So what am I hoping to draw here? I guess body double would be kind of insane. I mean, they're going to get to do some Fathom Searing, but I honestly don't care too much. Okay. Like, yes, they have some draw twos, but Pyromancer is just such a good card against them. Can I tell us more about the coffee? I can. It's Fair Trade Organic Coffee. It comes in a cold brew, canned. It's got a couple different flavors, a bunch of different flavors, like dark roast, vanilla, mocha, a Sunlance, my Talarian Sentinel. Didn't see direct damage coming. Okay. Well, it means our Kestrel gets to get in, but I still have a lot of really good outs here. And it can ship internationally. You get a discount. And I enjoy the coffee. I drank 2 cans of coffee during the stream. I think I decided to call it at that, though. And we decided to team up because it's a product I like and certainly one I can get behind. So I am a fan. All right. I need some action. Some kind of business. Let's hit with the Sinew Sliver. They have a Brine Elemental, maybe? It's X4. All right, let's just hit with the Sinew Sliver. Yeah, let's just hit with the Sinew Sliver. Shlomo Madrinas can answer that question for you. They can. He has a... All info. Oh, Whipspine Drake. Wow, am I going to lose this? I'm on my way. Kestrel plus Blink getting my Sacred Mace, so it was kind of a beating. Plains is not business. No, I would not qualify that as business. Someone asked where Madrina sources their beans. Shlomo. All right. Kavu would be great. Body Double would be great. The fact that I can't flashback my Think Twice is unfortunate. That's not bad. Play a Morph. I can flip. Oh no. What do they have? What is this? Spellburst with buyback? Guess I'm dead. Wow, I did not think I was going to lose this game. But I want to. Boo. Ooh. All right. Yeah, I thought I was going to 2-1. That was pretty unfortunate. Well, we were, in fact, promised a 2-1, but all right. We're not out of it yet. I'm not drawing another draft because, well, I'm going to do an Eternal draft. Maybe I'll win more in Eternal. I want to play a little bit of Modern. All right, let me end recording, though. Thank you for watching that Times Pro draft where I attempted the 2-1. Failed by a little bit, unfortunately.